In this video, I discuss the various types of petrol injection system in the detail. So first we see the classification of petrol injection system. So first it is classified in two main category. First one is the indirect injection, means petrol is injected in the intake manifold injection, means it is supplying manifold, that why it is called as the indirect. Means petrol is not directly injected into a combustion chamber, but it is spray into the intake manifold of the engine. Then second one is the gasoline direct injection. In short, it is known as the GDI. Direct injection means petrol is directly supplied to the combustion chamber or directly spray inside the combustion chamber, then it is called as the direct. So from its name we can easily understand, direct means it is directly spray inside the combustion chambers, and indirect means it is injected into the manifold of the system. Then indirect injection is further classified into the two category. First one is the single point injection and the second one is the multi-point fuel injection system. Suppose it is a four cylinder engine, then there is a two possibilities, that the petrol is injected at the only one point, and it is also possible to injecting the petrol in a multi-point fuel injection system, that we understand later on in this detail. Now single point injection system is further classified in two category. First one is the throat injection and the second one is the port injections. And multi-point fuel injection is also classified in two category. First one is the throat injection and second one is the port injections. Apart from this classification, the first it is depend on the continuous injection system and the time injection system, that we also understands. So we understand all these points in the detail. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video, and if you don't subscribe the channels, then subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe buttons, and also visit the playlist as well as in the description. Various link is provided for the IC engine as well as the various subject of the mechanical engineering. So first we understand the what is the basic two methods are used for petrol injections. The basic two method is the continuous injection and second one is the time injections. So from the name we can understand that the petrol is injected continuously, then it is known as the continuous injections. And the time injection means petrol is injected in particular time, then it is known as the time injections. In a continuous injection system, fuel is spray at the low pressure continuously into the air supply, and the quantity of fuel is controlled by air throttle opening and no timing devices used. Means quantity of fuel is simply controlled by the throttle opening, and this throttle is controlled by the accelerator of the vehicles. Second one is the time injection. So time injection is similar to the diesel injection system. Okay, in diesel injection system we know that at the end of the compression stroke we spray the diesels. So it is diesel is spray on particular time. So similarly in petrol injection system, in category of time injections, so at the end of the compression stroke the petrol is injected in a particular time, that's why it is known as the time injections. So meter quantity of the petrol is injected at a correct time and regulated by the speed of the engine. Petrol injection system was invented approximately before 20 years, and day by day number of modification takes place in these systems. So major classification of these systems are follows, that we already studied. Okay, that is a direct and indirect, single point, multi point and throttle and port type. Now we understand these in details. So in a indirect injection, fuel is injected into the air stream before entering to the combustion chamber as shown in this figure. Okay, so from the name we can understand, direct means it is supplied to combustion chamber. Indirect means the, here you see this is the fuel injectors, it is installed in the intake manifold system. Okay, this is the piston, this cylinders, this is the spark plug and this is the exhaust manifold. Okay, so here the petrol is injected into the intake manifold, not directly injected into the combustion chambers. Second is the direct injection methods. So fuel is injected directly inside the combustion chamber as shown in these figures. So here it is another image. So in a intake manifold only air is enters, it is exhaust manifolds, and here you see this is the combustion chamber and The fuel injector is putted inside the combustion chamber. So, fuel means petrol is directly injected inside the combustion chambers. So, we can understand simply from its name. The indirect injection can be classified as single point injection and multi point injection. The single point injection is also called as the throttle injections, in which fuel is injected one place in a throttle body as shown is the figure. Okay. So, now in this figure you see this is the 4 cylinder 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 intake manifold system. Okay. Now in a 4 you see here only one common fuel injector is provided. Okay. So, only one fuel injector is that. So, before supplying to this every cylinders, the air and petrol is mixed here and then after sink. So, instance of carburetor, fuel injector is put it. Okay. This is called as the single point. Okay. And in a multi-point what happen? For every cylinders, we are used the separate fuel injectors, that is known as the multi-point fuel injection system. And mix supply to the different cylinder means here you see that total injection in which fuel is injected one place in a throttle body as shown in this figure. So here fuel is injected. So air and petrol is mixed. Then after it is supplied to the every cylinders. In a case of pot injection, means pot injection is also known as the multi-point fuel injection. Air sucked through a throttle body and fuel is injected near the inlet valve of the every cylinder as shown in this figure. So here it is the new figure. Here you see only the air is enters. Okay. And the fuel injector is put it near the inlet valve. So this is the 4 cylinder 1, 2, 3, 4. So near the inlet valve fuel injector is put it. And here the 4 injector is used for a 4 cylinders. And in case of the single point injection, that is only one fuel injector is used. Now next one is the direct injection. In short, it is known as the DI. So in this system, petrol is directly injected inside the cylinders. So we already understand in last, okay, but here we understand in the details with advantages. Directly injected inside the cylinders at the end of compression stroke, similarly as the diesel injections. So we already know in diesel injection, diesel is sprayed at the end of compression. So similarly that way, petrol is injected at the end of compression stroke. So pressure required for the fuel injection is very high, about 40 to 65 bar. In a diesel engine, we know that the 70 to 100 bar pressure is required for injecting the diesel inside the cylinders in order to make better and quicker vaporization. Means this high pressure is required to make the better and quicker vaporizations of the petrol. Modern gasoline engines may utilize direct injections using electronic control unit, which is referred to as a gasoline direct injections. Means for this modern system, that is a one device is used, that is known as the electronic control units, that we understand in next to next video in this detail. Now what is the advantages of GDI? So first advantage is it give the better vaporizations. Second, it give the high volumetric efficiency. Third, easy to cold starting. Fourth, better performance at the idling, low load and the high load conditions. Means in a carburetors, we know that at the idling speed, low load and high load speeds, we are required a different air fuel ratio. But it is not possible to control in a carburetor systems. But in petrol injection system, we are able to control the air fuel mixer depending on the idling condition, low load condition and the high load condition. Fifth point is lower exhaust emissions when we control the air fuel mixer. So by default, we are able to control the exhaust emission. Next is the higher efficiency and better mileage. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video, and don't forget to share with your friends.